Hello and welcome to Jewelry Deconstructed. My name is Jerry and I would like to first remind you to hit the like and subscribe buttons right below here and that would be awesome. Thank you. This is going to be a very quick short video on how to make a sanding stick. Very simple item, but every jeweler uses them and you'll definitely need them. So this is a quick lesson on that. There's a few things you need. You need a flat surface to work on. So this doesn't work because it's a bench with all kinds of stuff in there, a sweeps tray. So grab something. I'm currently working on this project, but I can flip this over, put it on my sweeps tray, and I have a flat surface. To make a sanding stick, you need a stick. Ta-da. Here you go. When we're done, it's going to look something like this. Basically, a piece of sandpaper, a couple pieces of tape, taped to a stick. So we're going to put that in there. Actually, we'll put this in here where I keep them on my bench. That's where I keep all my sanding supplies. You need some sort of sharp point to square your paper. You need masking tape. And you need a piece of paper, sanding paper. Sandpaper, I guess, is the proper term. Now, you'll have a lot of different grits of paper. This particular one is 400 grit. I am replacing the paper on a sanding stick that I used up all the pieces. If you notice right here, I have the grit listed on there, 400. So it's easier for me when I'm digging in there and the different grits are all the same color paper. Same manufacturer, so it's easier to just look at the ends and boom, I can find the one I need. 400 grit. So this is a new sheet, but it is a little torn, but a little tear there is not going to make a big difference. Excuse me, I don't know where that came from. So the first step on this is you want to make sure that you have a piece that's not too flexy. This is a little over an eighth of an inch, maybe approaching a quarter inch thick, so it's not real flexible. I don't like them when they're flexible. I feel they don't work as well. So, also, you can have them anywhere from about 3/4 to an inch wide, which this one is. You can have them a little wider. You can have them a little bit narrower. It's up to you. You can do it on, this piece is rectangular. You can do it on a triangular piece of wood, which I've seen. I've never done it. Also, a round piece of wood. And where you're basically just doing the same thing and you're just rolling the paper. So, on a rounded dowel of different sizes. So, it gives you a little more flexibility with getting into spaces and spots and stuff. So let's get started. What you want to do is make sure that you take your piece of paper here and lay it down with the grit down because you're working on the back. You want to line up your stick as much as you can to the edge there, like as perfectly as you can. Now, by the time you're done rolling it, you might be a little off, but that's okay. Lightly score the paper like I did there. Very lightly, because you don't need it to be real hard. And this first piece, it'll just bend up. See how well that bent up? Like popped up real easy there. So you can see that the paper is bent easily. So we put that in there. You want to tuck the stick up against there tight to that piece. Another light score, and you should be able to just fold it out. And see, I was too heavy because look, I actually cut right through there. So we're going to rip this piece off. See how easy that came off? So very light score. I'll use that later for something else. So, okay. Very light. Fold it over. Now this is where it gets fun. Because you're now rubbing against the edge of the paper. You want to make sure that's tight. So so you can bring that paper over and keep it tight. Very light score. Hear that difference in sound? That's rubbing on the sandpaper now, the abrasive. And you just keep doing the very light scores. When I say a light touch, I mean very light. So, and I'm a little off on this. I don't know if it's, I cut the paper crooked or what. Oh no, there's a white spot right there. So that's going to be an issue. So, you have to back that up and rescore this, and hopefully you can fix it. Nope, I screwed something up there somewhere. Okay. You don't want to go back and redo this like I am. That is a perfect example of something you do not want to do. So, example of do as I say, not as I do. So, but you learn by error. So, I stood that up. Okay. Okay. I somehow scooted this out. Probably because I was busy talking and not paying attention to what I was doing. Okay. Much better. Yeah, see, now I've got that edge nice and about the size of the wood instead of that big white spot I had earlier. So, pull this in, make sure that's flush. And get a little piece off there, I'm not sure from what. That happens, and then this piece is, well, last piece, if it's really little, just do it hard, and take that edge right off. You're just trying to score it. Now, if you notice, that's on there really nice and tight, so. Put your hand on there, you grab your tape, which if I had been smart, I would have had a couple strips here already. Okay. Don't need much, like 3-4 inches. Okay, now you want to slide your stick in there and your paper to where you got a little bit of space on the top. And then you just kind of put your tape on there, wind it around. And there you go, you got one end. So, take off about another 3 inches or so. And you want to overlap the top of the paper with the stick. I just try to follow the top of the stick for the most part. And you get around there at least twice. So, and there you go. You have a 400 grit sanding stick. I put the stuff back up here. Set that down. Now the reason you use your dominant hand on the paper when you're folding is because of the direction of this opening. Okay, when you're putting your dominant hand here to score, that will ensure that this opening is facing away from what you're working on when you're working, and that's important. Let me What do I have here to file? I should have brought something to file. Okay. So when you're sanding on something, this opening is facing that direction. Because most people tend to file away from stuff. Now, I'm left-handed, so this works for me. So if I go to my right hand and I try to file, what happens is a lot of times you'll catch this edge and you'll just rip the paper. So always make sure that this paper is cut to where it's facing out with your dominant hand. So, and that way it works really well. And you have a little narrow edge. Now when you're done and this paper is all used up and worn, what you do is you just reach in there, you grab it off, and you just peel off the old piece and throw it in your tray for that to go to recycling, because you want to capture the metals that are stuck in the paper. So, and then you just make up a set of these for different grits that you normally use, and there you go. That is a basic lesson in how to make a very basic tool for jewelry. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please comment below or go to my blog, Jewelry Deconstructed. The links are also down below. And I will talk to you later. And I hope to hear some great comments. Thank you very much.